Hey everybody, it's Eric from epautos.com, your libertarian car guy. It's pouring and cold here in the woods, so bear with me as I try to do a quick walk around here of the 2018 Hyundai Sonata. It's been restyled for 2018, not radically, it's still basically the same car, same wheelbase, same length, same overall specifications, but fresh styling for the new model year. Mechanically, it's more or less the same. The big change is that the optional 2.0 liter turbo engine is now paired with an 8-speed automatic transmission. And as I was reviewing for the specs of this car, I was struck by how much your perspective can change in as little as 2 years. A couple of years ago, when this car came out, it really was a standout car in the mid-sized family car class, especially relative to the traditional blue chip cars, the Toyota Camry and, of course, the Honda Accord. Hyundais have always been really good values, gave you a lot of car for less money. But for the first time, they actually gave you more car for less money, and that was really something. But for 2018, both the Camry and the Accord have been completely redesigned, and they've really upped their game. Some of the noteworthy things about those cars relative to this car is that the new Camry and the Accord both come with stronger standard engines that also get better gas mileage, and they have much roomier interiors now, particularly in the back seat. Actually, I should put a caveat on that. The Sonata has the roomiest front seat in the class, but its back seat is a little bit more than 35 inches. The new Accord has a 40-inch legroom back seat, so substantial difference there. This car is still less expensive than either the Camry or the Accord, and that makes up for some of the game upping that Toyota and Honda have done this year. And in addition to that, this car also, in some ways, in my opinion, still has some advantages. You'll hear people talk about the wondrousness of the new 10-speed automatic that Honda is putting in the Accord with its optional 2-liter engine. But, you know, I don't know if I'd want to be the owner of the 10-speed automatic after the warranty runs out. And speaking of that, the one area where neither Toyota nor Honda have upped their game is in their warranty coverage. Those cars still only come standard with a 3-year 36 basic coverage and 5-year 60,000 miles on the drivetrain, whereas the Hyundai comes with a 5-year 60,000 mile coverage on the entire car and a 10-year 100,000 mile coverage on the drivetrain, and so that's very reassuring. And it's still really a nice car. It's just lost a little bit of its game versus the other two, but that doesn't mean it doesn't still have game. Anyway, I'm going to go back inside before this thing shorts out from the rain. I think Mr. Fuzz here probably wants to go back inside as well. And I should have a full review up on the site shortly. Also, there's an appalling piece, not my writing, just the subject of it, hopefully, about a run-amok cop in Tennessee who loves this shit, i.e. loves to kill people. So have a look at that, and thanks for viewing, and we will catch up with you again soon.